Hi friends, in this video we are going to see how to apply source transformation in order to get a current flowing through a particular resistor. So let's take a problem. So let's take a current source of 6 ampere. This resistor is 12. This is 36 volt, 6 ohm, 3 ohm, 2 ohm and 9 volt. The objective is you have to find out current flowing through this 3 ohm using source transformation. Again, choice of a source which we need to convert is very important, meaning I cannot consider this source for a transformation because this is a simple series circuit I will have. So obviously I will not touch this part. So only things remain is this. Here I can have this voltage source which I can transform into an equivalent current source, so that two current sources can be added. So let's check how to solve. So I am converting 36 volt voltage source into equivalent current source. So the value of current I is 36 divided by 12, which is nothing but 3 ampere. So let's redraw the circuit. So 6 ampere as it is, 36 getting converted into equivalent current source of a 3 ampere, positive polarity is upward, hence current direction is upward. 12 ohm will come in parallel with that current source, 6 ohm as it is we have not touched, and remaining part of the circuit will be as it is. So finally I will get this circuit, 6 ampere as it is. Here I will get a 3 ampere current source along with 12 ohm resistor, 6 ohm not touch, 3 ohm not touch, 2 remains as it is, and 9 volt battery will be as it is, and this is a current that we are supposed to find out. As we have discussed, here 6 ampere 3 ampere in parallel, both are having same direction, so resultant will be 9 ampere. 12 ohm 6 ohm also in parallel, so resultant we need to find out, so that I can say 6 ampere and 3 ampere are in parallel, so that resultant current, or I'll say equivalent current, will be 6 plus 3, 9 ampere. 12 comes in parallel with 6, resultant value of resistor 12 multiplied by 6 divided by 12 plus 6. So the answer you will get over here is 4 ohm. So the entire circuit can be reduced like this. I will have one current source and one resistor value. Remaining circuit will be as it is. So the resultant current source will be 9 ampere. Resultant resistor value we have calculated 4 ohm, 3 ohm as it is, 2 ohm will also remain as it is, and this 9 volt battery will be same, and this current we have to find out. Now we are very close to the answer. Only thing is that whenever we convert this current source into a voltage source, I will get a simple one loop circuit. So let's convert 9 ampere into equivalent voltage source. So voltage value will be 9 multiplied by 4, 36 volt. Let's redraw the circuit. So 36, 4 come in series, and rest of the part of the circuit will be as it is. So I'll quickly give the values to them. 36, this is 4, 3, 2 and 9, and we have to find out this value of current I. Now it is very simple circuit. I will have two batteries are connected in series opposition. The meaning of series opposition is same terminals are connected. So 36 and 9 are in series opposition. The resultant I will get is 36 minus 9, and remaining part of the circuit I will draw as it is. So 36 minus 9 I'll get 27, and rest of the part of the circuit will remain as it is. So here I can apply simple Ohm's law and get the value of I. So I is given as 27 divided by 4 plus 3 plus 2, which is a total series resistor, and ultimately I will get I as 27 divided by 9. So the value of current flowing through the 3 ohm resistor will be 3 ampere as it is. So here we have taken a problem where application of source transformation is required. In subsequent videos, we will solve more numericals based on this. Thank you.